Have you ever gotten out of a relationship and thought to yourself, dang, what was I thinking? Well, let's be honest, you probably weren't thinking straight, but seeing the relationship through rose-colored glasses. And there's nothing wrong with that, we've all done that. However, if you want to avoid it the next time, then stay tuned because I've got 5 signs you're idolizing a man or a relationship coming up next for you. Hola! Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Justine Palama, a dating and relationship coach, and I help single Christian women become their best selves so that they can attract a loving and healthy godly relationship. If you like these kind of topics, then make sure that you subscribe or head over to my blog where I have so many more topics for you to check out. The one thing that I do in my relationship coaching course, Becoming the One, is that I help my clients to identify the reasons why they want to be with someone that doesn't treat them right or why their past relationship didn't work out. I will ask them a bunch of questions, and whenever they answer them, we usually find out that they idolize the person or the relationship. For those of you who don't know what idolizing means, here is a quick definition. According to Merriam-Webster, idolatry is the worship, blind adoration, or excessive devotion to a person or a thing, meaning it's really anything that you put before God. When I find that out with my clients, it usually is a problem because the relationship or the guy became more important to them than being obedient to Christ. So what I find usually is that sometimes they want to be with that person so badly that they even risk disobeying God. And that obviously is a problem. It means that your focus is out of balance and getting you into trouble. So that's why today I thought it was only right to share with you 5 signs that you're idolizing a guy or a relationship so that you can change your behavior or get out of the relationship. Number 1 is that you ignore all the warning signs. If you watched my video on the 5 deal breakers in a Christian relationship, then you already know the red flags that give away that a guy is just not that into you or straight up playing you. And if you didn't watch it, no worries, I would link it up here, but at the same time, I'm sure that your gut already told you that something is off. It could be because he's doing some crazy stuff like entertaining girls on social media, that he's inconsistent and is MIA for like days or weeks at a time, or that whenever you want to talk to him about the relationship, he avoids or ignores you so that you forget about it eventually. But despite all the warning signs, you decide to stay because you idolize the potential of the relationship so much that you ignore your gut feeling and the Holy Spirit working inside of you to a point that you stay in a situation that you know is not right for you. Point number 2 is that you allow him to run all over you. It really is a follow-up point to number 1, because once a man realizes that you let all his wrongs slide, he now takes it a step further and blankly disrespects you. Instead of just liking pictures on social media, he now openly slides into other women's DMs, or he denies your status to other women and you find out about it. He basically keeps hurting you emotionally by disrespecting, manipulating, and undermining you over and over again. But the worst thing is that you allow him to. You find excuses for his behavior and ignore his actions. You want this to work out so badly that you accept his foolishness because you believe in his potential more than he strives for it. Number 3, and this one is really important, you get anxious at the thought of him leaving. When you idolize a man or a relationship, you're desperate for the approval of that person and want to make sure that he is good, even if it is at your own expense. So you start tiptoeing around that person. You never speak up if you don't like something. You're scared of showing your real emotions and feelings because you're scared that he gets mad or irritated about it. Instead, you try to find the mistake in yourself and decide that it's safer not to demand too much so that you can keep him. And you do that because you're anxious to lose him. So you do whatever it takes to keep him, even if it is at the expense of your own peace and well-being. Listen, number 3 is the fastest way to an unhealthy relationship because that behavior attracts manipulation and toxicity. So if you are that kind of person that gets anxious when you think somebody is about to leave, then make sure that you head over to justinefulama.com and check out my relationship coaching course, Becoming the One, where I will teach you how to gain more confidence so that you can attract a loving, godly relationship. Number four is that you are in love with who he could be more than who he is. And I think I briefly touched on it in point number two, but it is worth repeating anyways. As women, we oftentimes have a vision for our romantic relationships. We know what the man, the kids, and our hair will look like on our wedding day. But this thinking oftentimes sabotages our objectivity. Because when you first meet someone or only are dating, you really need to stay in the now and discern whether he is right for you or not. But because of that vision, a lot of girls start obsessing over the idea of who he could be and suddenly start testing out their first names with his last names just because he likes them. I get it. You see potential in him and that's good. But potential is not enough if he's not backing it up with real action. Number five is that you don't ask or listen to God. Listen, girls, this one might be too real for some of you, but I will say it anyways. Let's be honest, when we are in a relationship that doesn't honor God, or when we're with a guy that we know is not God's best for us, we get ashamed of talking to Jesus. Like, we try to hide the relationship from God as if he doesn't know. And our prayers are about everything but the guy. Because we know that if we would truly pray about the relationship and about him, God would be like, girl, what are you doing? So if you find yourself not listening to God, or better yet, not even asking for guidance, then that's a clear sign that you're idolizing the guy or the relationship. Because you've officially put this person before your obedience to God. These are all the points that I have for you today. But I want to leave you guys with a practical tool to help you discern whether or not you're idolizing a man or if he's really the one for you. That's why I'm gonna link down below my free ebook, 50 Questions to Identify the One. It's a practical resource that will help you girls to really look at the relationship objective and find out if this person is good for you. So scroll down a little bit, hit the link in the description box and download your free ebook. And if you enjoyed this video, then please leave me a like or share your comments with me down below. Either way, I would love to hear from you. And remember that I will be back next week with a new video. And if you're not good at remembering, then make sure that you hit the bell button so that you're notified when I upload something new. Until then, love and light.